it's also different what we see in television, the way biological experiments have done now. And just what was it all like, you know, in the old...
Well, of course, it seemed like the latest, hottest thing. one doesn't think of it as being not knowing what was coming next, and the speed with which new ways of doing things came was fantastic. And in fact, I often wonder whether or not whether the progress in experimental biology can't be, to some extent, measured in terms of the techniques. The machinery, the electron microscope, was a big leap forward, and there are many other, perhaps not quite as big a boom as that had, but pretty big. And I mean, there are things like techniques. Technique, for instance, of labeling proteins with a fluorescent label. So what we could do, and did, and that is, we took cells which are aggregated, and then put them under one of these fantastic microscopes, which would look for the fluorescence, and not only that, but could actually look at different layers, so that you can sort of make a dissection of where your fluorescence is. And what we could do, and I mean, once the technique is there, it's easy to do. once you're ready, you can put all these cells in a bunch, or natural or artificial gathering, and then put in, let's say, a spore protein which is labeled, and then you can actually see that these labeled spore proteins will go to one end or the other end, depending on whether they're stalk or spore, and it's mind-boggling. That was not even accessible to in the old days.
What sort of person did you have to be in the old days to do experiments well?
Well, I think you just had to be reasonably intelligent, not drop everything, and it didn't require fancy skills. But now, when I did these experiments with fluorescent things, I always did it with someone who knew what he was doing. And that didn't have to occur when I first started out. I could do it even though I didn't know what I was doing.